Hi, my name is Alyxandra Harvey, and I'm the author of Haunting Violet. Haunting Violet is the story of Violet Willoughby, who's a 16-year-old girl. She is the daughter of a fraudulent medium in 1872 Victorian London. Her mother essentially pretends to speak to the spirits of the dead for money and for payment, for food, for rent. They are a very poor family, and they're trying to basically get through society. Mediums were usually female in Victorian society, specifically for this reason. It gave them a place to have a respectable earning, and it gave them an excuse to do things that maybe they wouldn't be allowed to do as women in Victorian society. So her mother, who is a little high maintenance and not the easiest person to love, I have to say, pretends to speak to the dead. And Violet and her mother's servant, Colin, spend their time basically rigging up parlors and public halls to make it seem as if the dead are speaking back. So Violet will put bellows under her petticoat so that there's a cold wind under the table during seances, and they experiment with spirit boards, and they basically set up these little elaborate plays. They get invited to a country party in Hampshire, and it's a lord's estate. He's an earl, and basically he is a spiritualist and believes in speaking to the dead and believes that Violet's mother is actually a real medium. The trouble is Violet, who does not believe in ghosts, obviously, because of this sort of upbringing, starts to see ghosts at this party. And she sees them, of course, at a big seance with all of these very important people where it's very hard to hide that you've just seen this dead person sitting at the table with you. And she thinks she's going crazy, of course, because she has never believed in ghosts. But eventually the ghost of the girl reveals herself to be Rowena, who was murdered, and her twin sister, Tabitha, is also at the party and is in danger from the same person. So Violet and Colin and Violet's friend Elizabeth have to find out who murdered Rowena before the same person can murder Tabitha. And at the same time, Violet has to figure out how to control her gifts so that she's not ill all the time, she doesn't get these headaches from seeing these spirits, and doesn't essentially make herself out to be a crazy person in society.